Big 12 media days. Day one in the books, day two tomorrow. But for today, we had teams like Iowa State and, more importantly, Oklahoma, take the stage. Lincoln Riley, Jeremiah Hall, Nick Bonito were all there. And one of the questions people have been asking was, why isn't Spencer Rattler there? And the simple answer is basically that they've always taken, upperclassmen. They take your juniors and your seniors. So that makes sense at the end of the day when you look back and, Jalen Hurts didn't go, but he hadn't won the job yet. And then you have Kyler Murray, he didn't go. He technically didn't win the job yet, although there was that Austin Kendall, debate whether he was gonna start, but that didn't happen. But regardless, overall, nothing too groundbreaking today for media days. Bob Bowlesby talked today, and he was asked about about 11 a.m. kickoffs for Oklahoma and how, well, we signed the contracts, and it is what it is. We'll try to see if we can do better next time. And I don't know how happy Lincoln was about that. He wasn't even asked about it, like at the main media scrum or session today. But anyway, just things I took away from it overall is that Riley's positive as always, looking forward to the season. He's saying great things about Eric Gray, the offensive line, when he was talking to Dusty Dvorak on the Big 12 Now setup. Really excited about the offensive line, and there's a lot of confidence in the defense overall. So it's just one of those things where it feels like we're repeating ourselves over and over again, especially me, if you've been watching my content in the off season. It's just one of those things where we're almost halfway through July. We're just so close to the season, yet so far. Like, July can be tough at times, but we'll get through July, and August is when it's really going to feel like it's going to slow to a crawl, because we're going to be talking about college football on a daily basis, it seems, but we'll still have like 4 weeks just to get to a game. And September's creeping up, but overall, nothing earth-shaking. Iowa State Matt Campbell, he was asked about, all these job offers, better Power 5 gigs, better NFL jobs, like, you're still here. And he feels like a guy who's going to be there a while. And he talked about how, he had this saying, is like, you can either try to be somebody, or you can try to do something, or something. I'm paraphrasing there. But he sounds like a guy who believes he can really build Iowa State into a program. And as of right now, it's hard to argue with that, because when you break it down, after OU and Texas, who has the third largest stadium in the Big 12? Iowa State. Yeah, so that's what happens when you take away A&M and Colorado and Nebraska and Missouri and all that. So yeah, Iowa State's number three right now. So they may not be going anywhere. But overall, just kind of your regular run-of-the-mill media days. Nothing really big to report. But just excited about the. I think the one comment I really liked is that Riley compared the offensive line, that he was as excited as he was for 2018. And that O-line in 2018 was really, really good as well. So if the O-line, the one of the few areas I was kind of concerned about, not for talent reasons, but just for cohesion, if that works early on, Oklahoma is going to be in great shape for 2021. Really, really excited for that. And again, the defense, that front seven is going to be nasty, and got a lot to look forward to. Austin Jordan was dropped his commitment today to Texas, so there was a chance there was going to be a looked like Oklahoma early, but then as the tea leaves are being read throughout the day, everyone started dropping their confidence, and he flipped. He didn't flip. He picked Texas. So missed out on a four-star corner. Not too distraught over it, because if we're gonna go after a high-caliber four-star corner, I want to go in-state with Gentry Williams. I still feel really, really, really good about OU getting Gentry Williams at this point in mid-July, but we're still waiting to see on that. But with that being said, we have Media Day tomorrow. Texas is going to be the headliner for that one, and this is, Sark's got a lot to he's got a lot of questions to answer, and we'll see what happens there. Tom Herman, in my opinion, when his first media day, he failed it big time, because he looked lost and he looked scared. We'll see how Sark handles it. Maybe he'll do a better job when it comes to the media. But my opinion, it's going to be a rough year for Texas football if they don't find solutions to a lot of problems they have on that roster. So with that being said, still got some. We'll still probably get some more positive recruiting news later in the weekend. lot of it. Hopefully two, hopefully about three, you never know. And but with that being said, I'll see y'all tomorrow for just my thoughts on Big 12 Media Days Day 2. And then we'll see what else pops up during the week. Anyway, Boomer Sooner, you all have a good one, and have a good one. Said it twice. What am I thinking?